these are my some outputs I have obtained. So I'll explain you one by one. This is my first output, guys. So what this output is all about? This output is showing you the lung nodules 3D map. Basically, it is not showing the full lungs images or 3D measurement. It is only showing you the area of interest, region of interest portion. Because if I'm going to display that part, that will make a dense architecture and won't able to see you that where the nodule is existing. Thereafter, I extracted some of the nodule to show you that how these nodules look like. And finally, what is the my prime aim was to measure the nodules part where the nodules is located and what is the volumetric measurement of those nodules. So these are the nodules and the cancerous tissues, and the volumes is all is mentioned here, that the red nodule is having this much volume, the green one having lower volume, and things like that. So let's move toward the main. Hi guys, Ajay this side again, and today I have bring another tutorial of Health AI. So that was my stats I was talking about for patient who received no treatment. The cost of healthcare in the month of lung cancer diagnosis range around 10,000 to 13,000 USD. Here I'll show you my output first, and then I'll move toward the main program and try to explain you how to do understand it. So main program, you to show the data set which I have taken, and then I'll move forward the rest of the things. So let's move further, and I'll move toward the main program architecture. And give you a brief explanation for building the main part of the program. What I need to do first, I will close all the figure. Thereafter, take out all the warning. There are plenty of images available in my folder, but I have only taken few of images to make visualization better for you guys. Okay, the folder name is segmented images. I have taken 50 to 60 11 images for visualization. The extension was DCM, that means DICOM images. Okay, thereafter I'll read all the DICOM images and put it into a variable. On that variable I apply some thresholding function so that I would be able to get an output corresponding to it. Thereafter, I calculate the histogram, apply the thresholding, Otsu thresholding, which is quite famous for reducing the noise, and take out the binary output. Block propagation, where I can process each block in my program. After processing the block, what I do, I'll be getting an unsegmented output, which contain only the most dominating cells from the images. After getting those dominating cells, what I initialize, I end up with the thresholding, and I apply k-mean clustering to get the cluster of those nodules which is having different shape than the normal shape. After getting the k-mean cluster, after getting those cluster, I just make a batch of it. Okay, concatenate all the images. After concatenating all the images in a variable, I use a patch visualization here, which is a built-in function in MATLAB, with the help of it, I would be able to visualize the main portion of the 3D visualization of kidney. Thereafter, I move toward the second part of the algorithm. So let's run the program and see how it runs and how we would be able to see the outcomes. I run the program, it takes couple of minutes. Meanwhile, I would like to tell that I am a part of Research Infinite Solution, and we provide various kind of data science services. We provide dedicated one-to-one interaction, custom chat. You can hire AI developer from our organization, and we are the best in the known region. Okay guys, so don't hesitate, I have given my number on the bottom on the title section of the video. Just text me, put your requirement. If you are pursuing PhD, if you are pursuing masters, you can just text me and get So here my program is running, and you would be able to see that how the final the processing is performing. Thereafter, my each every images get will be structured in a sing one in three dimensional array, and I'll be getting an output like this. So guys, the green portion will showing the detected nodules. Now it's time to apply some machine learning on it so that we would be able to measure the volume. We will be able to do the volumetric measurement on it. And where is my program? Yeah, new threshold. So I have already explained you the concatenated native part modules. So it's time to get fed some already measured nodules from the skilled specialist and train our model corresponding to each nodule. My data is being put on TrainRC, that is a MAT file, and their label is being fed into Y matrix. Let me show you the TrainRC because it will be easy for you guys to understand the architecture and how I'm doing this thing. Let me clear it first and then load again MAT file. So these are the couple of samples, okay, and the volume contains some features, and their labeling will be associated at 20th scale. So after fetching those pre-trained isolated measured nodules, I put it into some variables, and I apply support vector machine because I have a small data, and support vector machine always perform best. If you haven't learned about support vector machine till now, just go my previous video. I have made plenty of video in support vector machine where I have explained and do and try to explain you the various application of support vector machine. But in this video, I'm making it short and brief. Here I train it using RBF kernel and classify it. I'll be getting an predicted nodules, and the corresponding to that nodule, okay, the outcome I extracted and measured the diameter of that nodules. Thereafter, do the volumetric measurement. After doing the volumetric measurement, it's time to filter some noise. For noise filtering, what I do, I use DB scan here, which give me the thresholding point. DB scan will do filter all the noise, and I'll be getting only the nodule part, and then I plot 3D clustering result, which is containing on IDX an output of DB scan and A. Okay, and finally, with the help of this 3D clustering result, I would be able to measure diagnosis the cancerous nodule. So let me run this program, and you will see the final outcome. So in this program, you will see various type of output after the process get complete. It takes couple of minutes. So meanwhile, I would like you to explain and remind you again that I am the part of Research Infinite Solution, provide various services in AI and healthcare domain. We provide thesis assistance for PhD and master's students also. We made proof of concept for the various startup. We do consultancy in AI domain, help them to grow in AI. And we also contribute with the help of this channel. Guys, don't forget to subscribe this channel if you like it. So after processing in few sec after processing for a few minutes, what I have obtained the same figure I have shown you in the beginning of the video, that the measured volume of red nodules, yet green. So sorry, green nodules, purple and cyan nodules will be shown at this, at here. And this is also a 3D architecture, and this will be drawn with the help of plot 3D clustering. So this is all about today's session. Thanks for watching this video, and please like, please do share, grow, because if more people work on healthcare and the diagnosis, things like that, then someday these things will be available to everybody, and nobody will be died because of non-diagnosis reason or their cancer get spread. Or so thanks guys, thank you for watching this video. Ajay this side, and bye-bye. I will next time I will bring you another video on whether in healthcare, reinforcement learning, deep learning, or something like